I want to tell you something so beautiful about this surah. Wallahi, one of the most beautiful things about Surah Ar-Rahman. The treasures of this surah don't come to an end. But just a few that I can share with you. You guys doing okay, by the way? How's the attention span? You getting sleepy yet? No? Okay. So, the last ayah of the surah. Anybody know the last ayah of the surah? Tabaraka smu rabbika dhil jalali wal ikram. The last ayah of the surah, Allah says that the name of Allah, the name of your Rabb, who is full of jalal, meaning jalal means glory that is not given to anybody else. Kalimat jalla la tusta'mal illa li rabbil alameen, illa lillah. The word jalla is not used except for Allah. You don't use, you know, dhul jalal for anyone other than Allah. You know, we say Allahu Azza wa Jal. Jalla is only for Allah. Now Allah says in that last ayah that the name of Allah is full of barakah. The name of Allah is full of barakah. Tabaraka smu rabbik. Tabaraka, the lazim form here, means something that is full of barakah. So we have to understand something about the word barakah. Just a little bit about the word barakah and which name. By the way, when Allah says the name of your master is full of barakah, did this surah begin with the name of Allah? Which name did it begin with? So Allah is telling us something about the word Ar-Rahman at the end of the surah. He's concluding with the beginning. He's telling us this name of Allah that I began with is full of barakah. Now it's Allah Himself, Tabarakallah. Allah Himself is full of barakah. But Allah is not talking about Himself. Allah is talking about His name. The name is full of barakah. So what does barakah mean? They say in Arabic, al-barakatu an-nama'u wa-ziyada. Barakah first of all means growth. Something that rises. An-numu, progress. Something that goes further and further. And increase. فوق التوقع, above expectation. If you put a seed in the ground, how many trees do you expect? One, you put a seed in the ground, you get 10 trees. That's not expected. That's what you call barakah. Barakah means logic says I should get one tree, but I got a whole forest. How did that come? That's barakah. Logic says I did one little thing. I expected one, you know, in like the, you know, Newton's laws, actions and reactions. Right? I did this action, I was expecting this reaction. But my one small action gave such a huge reaction. This must mean that the reaction has barakah. Barakah also in the Arabic language is used إِذَا أَنَاخَ الْجَمَلِ, when the camel settles and it doesn't move. It doesn't move, which is beautiful. Because when you grow something and you grow it too much, kids here will understand this. I think everybody will understand this. You guys know what Legos are, right? Legos. If you make a really tall tower with Legos, you keep putting one on top of the other, on top of the other, standing up. Does the tower become more stable or less stable? Becomes less stable, it's going to fall. The higher it is, the more chances it will fall, right? So when something becomes increased, it is less stable. But the word barakah means something that increases and is stable like a camel sunk in the sand. It doesn't move. In other words, don't think this increase will go away. It's not unstable increase. We know something about unstable increase in the United States. Our economy goes up really fast. And then what happens? Really fast. You know, it comes down really fast. There are, you know, governments that take over really fast. And when they take over really fast, guess what? They also disappear really fast. Happens all the time. It happens all the time, you know. So you have trends, fashions come really fast and then they disappear really fast. This happens all the time. But Allah says barakah is something that increases, but it what? It stays, it doesn't go away. And Allah says His name is full of barakah. What does that mean for you and me? You know what that means? That when we say Allah's name, Ar-Rahman, and we do something in Allah's name, with Allah's name, calling on the barakah of Allah's name, then whatever we do will produce good, but it will produce good more than expected, and the growth will continue and will not disappear. It'll keep going and going and going and going. You know, because of this one ayah, every Muslim is supposed to be an optimist. We can never be pessimists. Whatever you do, maybe, look, I'm standing here, there's thousands of you in the audience. There's so many others that are watching online. Thousands of you. But maybe one of you is a Quran teacher. And you don't have thousands of students, you have one student. You opened up your madrasa, you sat in the masjid, and one student came to you. One student. And you might think, how is this any, one guy shows up? What's the point? Imagine if I showed up here, we flew here, and one person was sitting in the audience. I'd be like, huh. But actually, this is just what I see, what you and I see. The barakah in teaching one person, the barakah in helping one person, the barakah in doing one good deed after you say Bismillahi ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The results of that you cannot calculate because they are from Allah and they will grow and grow beyond human expectation. Common sense, logic, mathematics cannot put it inside. You cannot encompass it. You don't know if that one child that you taught Alif and Ba to, that one child is going to be the next Mujaddid of this Ummah. That millions of people will take Shahada because of his da'wah and you started him on his journey. You don't know that. I don't know that. I can tell you personally a story of barakah. When I started learning Arabic, the Arabic language, I was curious about the Quran. I read it in English, but I read a Shakespearean English translation. It was really hard to understand because when I was reading "Hast thou not seeneth," I was confused because I've never talked to my friend and say "Hast thou not seeneth this movie?" Like I don't talk like that, so I couldn't figure out what it's saying. Really, I had a hard time. So I decided, I found a teacher who said he can learn Arabic with me. And when we were in the Arabic class, I still remember, there were 10 students in the Arabic class at the masjid after Ramadan, 10 students on the first day. This class was going to go on for 3 weeks every day, every evening. 10 students the first day, 9 students the second day, 6 students the third day, 3 students the fourth day. And I look around and I'm like, should I also leave? I don't know. And the teacher on the third or fourth day, he said, look, people will come and go. And even if none of you come, I will still be here waiting for you. I'll still be here waiting for you. You know why? Because when we do something for Allah, then we don't expect from people. We only expect from Allah. I get paid from Allah, not from you. I'm here for Allah. And when he said that, he believes in barakah. He believes in barakah. Now there's 3 of us sitting in this class. And even I'm sitting there learning this stuff. And I'm like, what's the point? You know, I might learn this in 3 weeks, but how am I going to do any more than that? I'm sitting in New York City. I don't have the money to go to Egypt or to go to Cairo or to go to like Morocco or go to Pakistan or Malaysia to study. And I don't have that. I got to sit here and get a, you know, I come from work and college and do this. For 3 weeks, what am I going to do after that? How am I ever going to learn? But when Allah puts barakah in something, that's not up to us. That is not up to us. When I look back from since 1999 to now, the announcer said I've taught 10,000 students. In an accurate estimation, I would say, subhanAllah, till now, live audience, I must have taught at least 70, 80,000 people. Live audiences. And just the Arabic classes alone, not durus of Quran, Arabic classes. You know Arabic classes are boring, right? Arabic classes, at least I've seen 20,000 people in Arabic classes. Physically, I've gone, you know, state to state in the United States and taught. I've seen that many people, you know, subhanAllah. And I did not, that's not from me. That's not from me. That's when Allah decides He'll give some barakah. That's up to Him. Don't underestimate the value of the things that you do. Don't underestimate them. That's up to Allah. When He puts barakah in it, it will come beyond your expectations. You will never, مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ. Allah will provide from where you can't even imagine.